In this lecture, I would like to discuss about introduction to polymers. The word polymer is derived from two Greek words. Poly means many and mer means a unit or a part. In 1833, Jacob Berzelius has explained and has derived the word polymer. Polymer structures can be represented by a similar or identical repeat units. Poly means many and mer means molecule. So in a simple way we can define polymer. Polymer are the substances having many molecules, large number of monomer units or different units are present in the polymer. That each unit is called as a monomer. So you can see here some examples are given. Monomer, ethene molecule. Now the repeat unit, it is this ethylene, and the name of the polymer, it is polyethene or polyethylene. Another example, it is propene. It is a monomer unit. So this is the repeat unit. So it is polypropylene, the polymer which is derived from this. So number of examples are given here. So polymers are the substances which are having many repeat units of monomers. Polymers are the giant molecules where the molecular weight of the polymer is very high. Now, how these polymers are formed? These polymers are formed by the process, and that process is called as polymerization. So polymerization is a process in which low molecular weight compounds, that is monomer, for example, ethene molecule. So polymerization is a process in which low molecular weight compounds are linked together, forming a high molecular weight compounds. The process by which the polymer is formed, it is called as a polymerization process. So you can see here, this is monomer, n number of monomer units get combined, get linked to each other, and this polymer is formed here. So in this case, n is called as the degree of polymerization. So what do you mean by degree of polymerization? What do you mean by degree of polymerization? Degree of polymerization, or in short, it is DP, is defined as the number of repeat units present in an average polymer chain at time T in a polymerization reaction. It is nothing but the number of repeat unit. For example, here the repeat unit, it is six monomer units are here repeated in an average polymer chain. In an average polymer chain at time T in a polymerization reaction. So the size of the polymer chain is decided by this number. That is called as a degree of polymerization. Polymers are repeat of smaller units. We can say that polymers are macromolecules. But actually, in macromolecule, they may not have a repeat unit or may have the repeat unit. Example, hemoglobin is a macromolecule, but it is not a polymer. okay, but polymer molecules are having the number of repeat units. Now let us going to discuss the classification of polymers. Classification of polymers. We know that polymers are the molecules who are having number of repeat units. Poly means many, mer means molecules. So polymers are classified by three ways: based on source, second, based on structure, third, based on thermal response, and fourth, based on physical properties. By the four way we can classify the polymers. So let us see, based on source, there are three types of the polymers: natural polymer, synthetic polymer, semi synthetic polymer. Based on structure, linear polymer, cyclic polymer, branched chain polymer, and cross linked polymers. Then based on thermal response, thermoplastic and thermosetting. And last one, based on physical properties, there are four class: elastomers, plastics, fibers, and liquid resins. So in this way polymers are classified. Let us going to discuss one by one. Classification of polymers based on source, first type. Now polymers are classified according to the source. There are three ways: natural polymers, synthetic polymers, and semi-synthetic polymers. Natural polymers, synthetic polymers, and semi-synthetic polymers. So what are natural polymers? The polymers obtained from nature, particularly from plant and animals, are called as natural polymers. They are naturally occurring, therefore they are called as natural polymers. These polymers are very essential for life. For example, starch, it is a polymer of glucose. It is a food reserve of plant. Cellulose, it is also a polymer of glucose. Okay. Proteins are very essential to us. These are polymers of alpha amino acids. Alpha amino acids are the building units which are present in the proteins. Okay. Generally, they have 20 to 1000 alpha amino acids joined together. So therefore, they are called as proteins. Okay. Then nucleic acids. It is also the example of natural polymer. So these are polymers of various nucleotides. For example, RNA, DNA are common nucleotides. So this is about natural polymers. Naturally, they occur: starch, cellulose, proteins, and nucleic acid. Then synthetic polymers. The polymers which are prepared in the laboratories, the polymers which are prepared in the industries are called as synthetic polymers. They can be synthesized. These polymers are also called as a man-made polymers. You can see here. These polymers are called as a man-made polymers. For example, polyethylene or polythene. Okay, this is a synthetic polymer obtained from ethene molecule or ethylene molecule. Polyvinyl chloride, nylon, teflon, bakelite, terephthalate, synthetic rubber. These are the synthetic polymers, examples of synthetic polymers. Then semi-synthetic polymers. Semi-synthetic polymers. These polymers are mostly derived from naturally occurring polymers. Those polymers who are naturally occur, for example, starch, cellulose, proteins, that polymers are naturally occurring polymers. So semi-synthetic polymers are derived from naturally occurring polymers by chemical modification. By doing some chemical modification into that, these polymers can be synthesized. Therefore, they are called as semi-synthetic polymers. For example, cellulose. Cellulose is a natural polymer. Okay. Now cellulose on acetylation. If we perform the acetylation reaction on the cellulose with acetic anhydride, okay, in the presence of the sulfuric acid, the cellulose diacetate. This semi-synthetic polymer is formed. Cellulose diacetate. It is a semi-synthetic polymer. It is formed here. Okay. Then another example. It is vulcanized rubber. It is also semi-synthetic polymers. It is used in making tires, gun cotton, etc. Okay. Cellulose nitrate is used in making explosives. It is also semi-synthetic polymer. Rayon and other cellulose derivatives like cellulose nitrate, cellulose acetate. Okay, these are the examples of the semi-synthetic polymers. Okay, so viscose rayon in the form of thin transparent film is known as a cellophane. It is also the semi-synthetic polymers. So number of examples are given here for the semi-synthetic polymers. So what are semi-synthetic polymers? These polymers are mostly derived from naturally occurring polymers. Some treatment it is given to the naturally occurring polymers, and some chemical modification is there. Okay, so these polymers are derived from naturally occurring polymers. Okay, so this is about the semi-synthetic polymers. Now, second type of the classification of polymers based on structure. So there are four types are given here: linear polymers, cyclic polymers, branched chain polymers, and cross-linked polymers. Linear polymers, then cyclic polymers, branched chain polymers, and cross-linked polymers. So let us talk about linear polymers. So these are the polymers in which monomeric units are linked together to form a linear chain. Okay. These linear polymers are packed together and a high magnitude of intermolecular forces of attraction, and therefore they have high densities, high tensile strength, and have high melting point. Some common examples of the linear polymers are polyethylene. Okay, linear polymer, polyethylene, you can see polyethylene, we can represent this polymer in this way. Okay, polyethylene. Okay. So this is a linear polymer. Okay. Linear polymer, polyethylene, nylon, polyester, PVC. Okay, these are the examples of the linear polymer. Cyclic polymers, cyclic olefin copolymer, COC, is an amorphous polymer. COC, that is cyclic olefin copolymer, is relatively new class of polymers. Okay, this is a newly developed polymer. This is newly developed material. It is used for packaging films, lenses, vials, displays, and medical. Okay, cyclic polymers. Then branched chain polymers. These are the polymers in which the monomers are joined. In this case, the monomers are joined to form long chains with side chains. For example, like this. Suppose that this is a carbon-carbon chain, and if there is a some side chain as like of this, okay, side chain as like of this, then it is called as a branched chain polymers. These branched chain polymers are irregularly packed, and therefore they have low tensile strength, low density, boiling point, and melting points than linear polymers. Okay, some common examples of low density polyethylene, glycosine. It is an example of the branched chain polymers. Starch. It is also the example. Amlopectin. It is the example of the branched chain polymers. Okay, then cross-linked polymers. Third, four type here. This is four. Belongs to classification based on the structure. So these are the polymers in which monomer units are cross-linked together. Cross-linking is there to form a three-dimensional network. In this case, there is a formation of the three-dimensional network. Okay, So these polymers are particularly hard, rigid, and brittle because of network structure. Example of cross-linked polymer, it is bakelite, melamine, formaldehyde, resin. Okay, so these are the examples of the cross-linked polymers. Okay, monomer units are cross-linked together, and there is a formation of the cross-linked polymers. Then the next classification, that is classification of polymers based on thermal response. Okay, now there are two classes are given here: thermoplast and thermosets. So what is about the thermoplast? Classification of the polymers based on thermal response means effect of temperature is there on such polymers. So first of all, thermoplast. So what are thermoplasts? These are the polymers which are softened when heated. When we supply the heat, they can be softened, and hardened when cooled. Okay, when we cooled it, it becomes hardened. Simultaneous application of heat and pressure is required to fabricate these polymers. Okay, on the molecular level, when the temperature is raised, secondary bonding forces are diminished, so that the relative moment of the adjacent chains is facilitated when a stress is applied. Okay, the examples of thermoplastics are polyvinyl chloride, okay, and polystyrene, polymethyl methacrylate, polystyrene. Okay, so these are the examples of thermoplast. Actually, these polymers are softened when heated and hardened when cooled. Okay, so when we apply the heat, they become soft, and when we cool them, they becomes very hard. So the examples are polyvinyl chloride, all of us know PVC pipe, okay, and polystyrene, polymethyl methacrylate. Okay, this is about thermoplast. Now thermosets, second polymer, classification based on the thermal response. So you can see here thermosets. Thermosets. Okay, thermosetting polymers become soft during their first heating. When we supply the heat, they become soft, and become permanently hard when they are cooled. Okay, later on we cannot make them soften. Thermosetting polymers become soft during their first heating, and become permanently hard. Become permanently hard when they are cooled. Later on, we cannot make them soft by heating. They do not soften during the subsequent heating. Hence, they cannot be remolded or reshaped by subsequent heating, while thermoplast can be molded. Okay. So in thermosets, during the initial heating, generally covalent cross links are formed between the adjacent molecular chain. Okay, so that's why they cannot be heated again and again. Okay, so only heating to excessive temperatures will cause severance of these cross-linked bonds and polymers degradation. Actually, after the heating, many times they can be decomposed. They can be degraded. Okay, so this is the difference between the thermoplast and thermosets. In case of the thermoset, when we can supply the heat, they can be softened. When we cool them, they can be hardened. When we supply the heat, they can be softened. So this process is continuous there. But in case of the thermoset, when we supply the heat, first heating, they can be softened. But when we cool, they are permanently hard. Okay, so this is the difference between the thermoplast and thermosets. Okay, the examples of thermosets polymer, it is vulcanized rubber, epoxy, phenolic, polyester resins. So these are the examples of thermosets polymers. Then the last classification of polymers, it is classification of polymers based on physical properties. Classification of polymers based on physical properties. So you can see here, first it is elastomers. So elastomers are polymers in which the polymer chains are held by weakest intermolecular forces. There is a weak intermolecular forces between the monomer units. Okay. and these four forces permit polymers to be stretched. We can stretch it. Okay, so few cross links are introduced between the chains to help the polymer retract to its original position. So it is also the type of the cross link polymer. Okay, so for example, vulcanized rubber, we can stretch the rubber, so it is a elastomer. Then plastics, second classification, these are usually much stronger than elastomers or rubbers. Okay, plastics are hard, rigid, stiff. Okay, and they are stable. Okay, examples of plastics, it is polyethylene, polystyrene, these are the examples of the plastics. Then next, it is fibers. These polymers possess high tensile strength and high modules because of the strong intermolecular forces like hydrogen bonding, which operate in polyamides. Okay, fibers. These strong forces are also lead to close packing of chains and thus impart crystalline nature. So fibers supposed to be having the crystalline nature. As a result, these polymers show sharp melting points. They are having the sharp melting points, fibers. Okay, these polymers are used for making fibers, example nylon, terephthalate, etc. Liquid resin polymers used as adhesive, sealants, where particularly in the window sealing, they can be used in vehicles. The glass can be sealed with the help of these polymers. Okay, in a liquid form belong to this class. Okay, examples include epoxy adhesives and polysulfide sealants. These are the liquid resins. Okay, so this is about the classification of the polymers. There are four types of the classification based on source, classification based on structure, classification based on thermal response, and classification based on physical properties. So in this way, we can classify the polymers here. Okay. So thus, in this lecture, we explain about what are polymers. Polymers are the compounds who are having many monomer molecules, many monomer chains, and it is having the high molecular weight.